Welcome back to my channel. Today I received my Thrive Markets box for stuff that I needed. So I'm just going to unbox it real quick and we're going to check out and see what we got. I totally forgot what I ordered. So I believe it was a lot of snack items that I wanted to try. I am. I'm going to make your dinner in just a minute, baby. You finish your pretzels. All right. Okay, good job. So I always love how they wrap everything really nice and lots of paper. What do you need to tell me?
This is a circle.
Oh yes, it is. Your pretzel is a circle. Yes. Okay. So I love how they like wrap everything as she's talking to me in the background. So they really take care in making sure everything is wrapped very nice and even in plastic after the fact. So I did get the expeller pressed avocado oil, which I want to say is 10, 11 bucks, which I needed some oil. This is the Pizza Ranch by Sir Kensington. So it's the Pizza Ranch. I believe I ordered the regular ranch, which I heard from a lot of people that is like the best ranch you'll ever have. I did want to try these. I needed some snack items for work because I'm trying to do a little, I do like to snack. So if I can spread my meals around and just maybe have two snacks in between instead of a meal, it's a little bit better for me. This helps me a little bit better. So I got this one, which is I don't know why the light seems, maybe if I turn it that way. Sorry, the light's a little weird in here today. And the camera does not want to cooperate, of course. All right. So, I got this paleo snack mix, which is like a Chipotle barbecue. And it looks like it has like cashews, walnuts. It's gluten-free, vegan, and grain-free. So, it's actually for a third of a cup is 150 calories. It has 10 grams of fat and 13 grams of carbs minus the sugars. They've added sugars in here, so it's really like 10 grams for this, but I don't always count like all my carbs, so this is a great little snack item. Let's see if I can get a little bit, maybe that's a little brighter. Yeah, okay, there we go. Here's another one that I got too, which is also a paleo snack mix, non-GMO. This one is a savory. Yes. Because it was brighter for the camera. This is a savory one, and it looks like the same thing. It's got pecans, cashews. It almost looks like banana chips, but I can't really tell. But another little snack option for me for work. This I saw somebody had too. It's a chocolate chunk soft baked cookies, only 6 grams of sugar. So it's sweetened with coconut sugar and dates. Sounded really interesting to try, so I got that. A lot of snack stuff. So I did pick up a few of these at Trader Joe's. Trader Joe sells them. It's like $1.69 for one stick, which is a little pricey. This one you get actually, I want to say it's 10 or 12 sticks. There's 10 sticks in here. They're 90 calories for each stick. It's a great snack option with the nuts. I really have been doing that a few times for work. That's grass-fed, finished beef, vegetarian-fed diets. No sugar, no gluten, nuts, soy, milk, pork, no preservatives. But I love like jalapeno. I like spice. So this actually is really very tasty, and it really hits the spot. It's protein, so it's like an extra little kick to help you like midday, so you need them. And I want to say they're on sale right now for $19.99 for 10 of them. Alright, I think this is the ranch dressing. Yes. So this is the ranch dressing and marinade. It's made with actually MCT oil, which I didn't realize. It's dairy-free, soy, and canola-free. It's actually for 2 tablespoons, it's 140 calories and has no carbs. 15 grams of fat though, but no carbs. I also got the avocado oil spray. I can always use an extra, so it was just something to add into my cart basically to get free shipping. I want to say it was like $4 or $5. I got these also. They're grain-free, Lillibee's grain-free brownie thins. And these also have 9 carbs, basically. So, but 4 grams of protein, they're only 100 calories, and they're paleo-friendly or keto-friendly, probably if you still want to have like a snack. Okay, I'll be there in just a minute. You really need to tell me. And for little Peanut over there, I got these. I thought she would like these by Annie's. They're the cheddar bunnies and they come in the little packs. So it's actually 12 packs. So I thought she would really like that for a snack. So I did pick these up for her. So I don't think, I wonder if they have, yeah, they don't have a, like a receipt in the box. They used to put a receipt in the box, but they don't anymore. But I want to say everything was around $50 and you get free shipping. But these are some like good snack options to try. So I really wanted to mix my little snacking up a little bit. I did get some containers from Amazon that I'm going to wash out and that these, a lot of these snacks can fit into. And we're going to stock up our mudroom, like my snack area for that. So this is just going to be a great little snack option. So Thrive Market is, okay, baby, I'll be right there. Okay, I'll be right there. I know you really need to tell me something. The one thing I like about Thrive Market is I can order stuff really easily. Okay, just 1 minute. Madeline. Okay, so the thing I like about Thrive Market is it's a $60 a year for the subscription. If you order over $40, maybe $50, I think you get free shipping all the time. I do like the fact that they have a lot of gluten-free items. They have a lot of paleo or different kind of snack items that sometimes you might not find in the store. If you're somebody that likes keto or you know, these grass-fed chomps are like a great item. I was really surprised how much I actually like them over like for a beef stick. Everybody usually has like a Slim Jim, but the sodium and everything that's in the Slim Jim versus these is, yeah, like this has only got 290 mg of sodium, or I want to say Slim Jims are a lot higher because they're a lot saltier. These really aren't that salty, but I do like the fact that it's grass-fed and finished beef, so you are getting like better ingredients in this than you would like a Slim Jim. And the stick is the same size as this box, so it's still a good, you're getting a good treat, and you can even cut it in half if you wanted to have half one, half later. But a lot of these options are really great snack options for snackers. People want to try something new. I did purchase some nuts at Trader Joe's the other day that were everything bagel nuts. Like, they're trying to like come up with like different things that are a little bit more to the consumer's eye type deal, or taste buds and stuff like that. So these are some great things that I literally wanted to try. Okay, I'll be right there. It's bubble guppies. Why do I not like it? Your tummy hurts? Okay. That means you need to eat. So I need to go make her dinner. But all in all, this was a pretty good snack option for Thrive Market. And if you guys want to try, I will leave stuff in the description box below. Thank you for subscribing to our channel and we'll see you later. Bye. Okay, what'd you find? Found a new friend besides the geese. Those are just rocks, silly.
No.
What are you looking for?
I'm looking for the new friend.
A new friend? Can you get the geese? Watch, see, watch where they go.
Daddy, stop!
Okay. Oh, I see three of them. Careful.
Look at them go.
Careful, Maddie, careful. Dad, do it first.
The dad needs to fly.
The dad needs to fly. There he goes. Okay, the other one's gonna follow. I don't know, baby. I don't know. I don't know where they went.
Don't mind, where the daddy one go?
I don't know where the daddy one went.
I think daddy one is gone.
No, he'll be back.
And so mom geese do it.
Well, she's
go,
just...
mama geese.
Yes, baby.
I think so.
Who's calling you? The geese?
Mommy.
Yes, baby.
What is that baby geese doing?
Oh, that's not a baby. That's a grown geese. They're grown-ups. Sitting there waiting.
I see waiting for daddy one.
I don't know. Maybe they've decided they don't want to fly. Because they've decided they don't want to, I guess. They're shy.
I think mama's gonna fly first.
Okay, careful. No, 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 no. Stay away, baby.
No, why stay away?
Because they're not nice animals. Stay right here, okay? No, they're not gonna fly. They're taking the easy way out. They're just getting in the water. There they go. They're going to go swimming.
Where's the daddy one?
I don't know. He flew somewhere. I don't know. Say bye, geese.
Bye, geese.
I see you later.
Daddy one flew the way over there.
Say see you later, geese.
I need to see him way close.
No, no, no. You can't go any closer. Madeline, close enough. Say bye, geese.
Bye, geese.
Uh-oh, the stroller. Come on, let's catch the stroller. Well, I got some stuff from Whole Foods, and we went to Costco. So the celery was from Costco, but all this is from Whole Foods. So Whole Foods has the dandelion greens, so those are going to be good for my detox. And I believe I got cilantro and parsley also that I already put in the fridge. But these, I have never ever seen this at Costco. I saw these at Costco today and I picked them up. So I've never seen turmeric anywhere. So I was quite impressed. And I want to say the price tag on this was like $6.99. So it was really great find. We have kind of a mixture because I kind of just set everything here. So the chamomile tea and the detox tea is for my detox. These are from Whole Foods. And I'm going to make these hanger bombs, which they have the raw hazelnuts, which I'm so excited for. And then, of course, a few limes for some cilantro lime and one avocado. This is also for the hanger bombs. I've never found this any place either, but Whole Foods definitely had it, which was awesome. Cucumbers for the juicing. I picked up some Nan at Costco for Maddie because she, of course, loves them. Now, this was a new find at Costco today, too, was the concentrated cold brew by Starbucks, which I love my Starbucks. So you will have to, I thought this really was, I want to say it was $11.99, and it's two of these 32 ounce, I think. Let me see. Yep. Two 32 ounce bottles of the concentrate, and you only use 4 ounces of the concentrate with 4 ounces of water, or you could use 8 ounces with however you make your coffee. I tend to like a big coffee. Don't mind Maddie's bowl. This was another thing that I found at Costco today too, which I was really impressed with too, which was the organic ginger. This thing is huge, and $7.99 maybe for this, which was a really good deal also. So I put quite a lot of stuff away, but these are just like the few little things that I did leave out from Whole Foods and Costco. A lot of good greens today at Whole Foods. Whole Foods did have a lot of really good stuff, but other than that, between the two, we did pretty good. All right, messy hair day. Welcome back to our channel. Maddie is napping. Finally, she's had a very rough day, and that's why this is taking a little longer to finish today, because it's not terrible twos, it's terrible threes, and terrible threes in which she doesn't want to listen, and the word no is not in her vocabulary. So when you say no, she does everything else but what you said. So we've had a rough day of trying to learn how to listen. So, and mommy has a headache, but a lot to straighten up while she's napping, so we're definitely going to do that. And then I'm going to put together a few green drinks, hopefully get done for later today and for work for tomorrow. I also have to steam some broccoli. I did get a rotisserie chicken also at Costco, so that's going to go in my detox soup. And then we're going to have a few other little things that I have to get straightened out, but other than that, let's go.
Found a way, yeah. But you never go away. So I guess I gotta stay now. Oh, I hope someday I'll make it out of there, even if it takes all night. Oh, 100 years, need a place to hide, but
sugar-free maple syrup, which I thought I had an extra one. I did not. Whoops. And I thought I had cocoa powder or cacao powder, and I don't. So I'm going to order those really quickly at Target, and hopefully I can get them shortly, and hopefully there's nothing else that I'm missing. Let's hope. Okay, so unfortunately the day has gotten the best of me completely, and the kitchen is a disaster, but the hanger bombs are finally made after the trip to Target to get the leftover, or what I was missing from the recipe. You are going to take a bath today in just a minute, okay? I also just made a detox liver smoothie. I will actually say it actually tastes pretty good because it's it has coconut milk, the dandelion greens, frozen pineapple, a like cube of fresh ginger. I did add a little water and ice because my blender was giving me a hard time, but I did make enough for the next, I believe I have enough for the next 2 days, maybe 3 days, depending on if I just do this much, which is a nice size. Has, I think it's a frozen pineapple, it has spinach and the dandelion greens, which surprisingly, the ginger gives it like a little kick, but it is pretty good. So I'm gonna finish that. I'm going to clean up the kitchen and I'm going to unbox my HelloFresh box that came so I can put it down in the basement. But I'll show you what meals I got this week. I'm not making them right now, but I will show you guys what I got. So first, let's clean the mess. Look at your legs. Why? All right. So here is the HelloFresh for this week. And unfortunately, I also get every plate. And the boyfriend wanted takeout on Sunday, so I did not make one of those meals. So I guess I'm gonna have to make one this week. Oh, this is different. I'm gonna have to make one of them this week for him to have for like his lunches and stuff. So, and this week's, I'm really excited to try these. So I got the Tex-Mex pork pepper enchiladas, which I love. We got the buffalo spice crispy chicken cutlets, which is actually new. I haven't seen that one yet, so I can't wait to do that one. And then this one looks, oh, delicious. White cheddar Wonder Burgers and Old Bay fries. So, three really good selections this week. So, I'm very happy with those. And I've shown these before, but I really love how they package it. I love how they give you the bag. Like, it comes in the bag, so all the trash goes in the bag, and it's just easier. It's also easier to store in my fridge downstairs if they are individually wrapped. Yes, baby. I'm unboxing our stuff. I am. And because I probably... I will in just a minute. And because I might not get to them right away, I can actually throw... Yes, baby. I hear you. Okay. In just a second. I can actually throw these if I don't get to them, like, by Friday. I'll probably just throw them in the freezer because these actually do last a long time, and everything in the fridge lasts really well. Sometimes like a pepper might go bad or something, but yes, in 1 minute, 1 minute, please. In 1 minute, did you finish your dinner? Finish up your dinner, please. But all in all, they freeze really easy, and my fridge downstairs is a little colder, so everything does stay a little bit colder. Madeline. As I was saying, she was rudely interrupting, of course. 3-year-old, you know, she's first one, gotta be first in everything. But so if I don't get to these, I'll probably freeze them. Now I do think like the burger, he'll like that. The buffalo chicken, he probably will like. Actually, these are all pretty good ones for like next week, for my weekend, for like Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. But all in all, I love the packaging. I love the way they come easily to freeze and just take out. And these, as I said, my fridge downstairs is a little colder than my fridge upstairs. And it's one of those, the big fridge on the bottom with the freezer on the top. So it's just a little easier to store everything down there. But they did change their packaging. So it's kind of, I mean, it's not, it's kind of nice. It's a little bit nicer. So yeah, out to the garbage with the rest of the garbage I've got to take out today. But I have some hard-boiled eggs in the Instant Pot, which is the easiest way to make them. Who knew? And I just have like my meal prep for work to get ready. And other than that, it's gonna we're gonna call it a night. We have bath time and potty training, of course. What else to do with a three-year-old? But continue to potty train a very defiant three-year-old. So, we will bid you guys adieu, and we will see you guys. This will probably go, because my day kind of got away from me. Instead of Tuesday, it's gonna go up for tomorrow. So we'll just do a video for today. Included in this video, we did do the HelloFresh, and I also have a Thrive Market little shopping that I did to get some snacks for Madi. Which actually turned out to be snacks for both of us, but her snacks actually turned out to be a hit. She really liked them. So all stuff to go in our little snack section over there. We've already started loading it. So hopefully this week I'll get to the labels, and then next week we can show you the finished product. Other than that, enjoy your week, and we'll see you guys on Sunday. Bye, and thanks for subscribing to our channel.